ಗುಜರಾತ್ ಮರಾಠ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ ಉತ್ಕಳ ಬಂಗಾ ವಿಂಜ ಹಿಮಾಚಲ ಯಮುನಾ ಗಂಗಾ ಉಚ್ಚಲ ಜಲಧಿ ತರಂಗಾ ತವ ಶುಭ ನಾಮೇ ಜಾಗೇ ತವ ಶುಭ ಆಶಿಷ ಮಾಂಗೇ ಗಾಹೇ ತವ ಜಯದಾತಾ ಜನ ಜನ ಮಂಗಳದಾಯಕ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಭಾರತ ಭಾಗ್ಯ ವಿಧಾತಾ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ 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 ಹೇ
ದೀಪ ದೀಪ ಹಾಂ ದೀಪ ಜಲ್ದಿ ಹೋ ರಹಾ ಹೈ
across the country and ready the next set of leaders for the country. Today, I have come to Agra chapter. First, I would like to call the General of the Indian International MUN United Nations Agra chapter, Mr. Jivesh Garg, to come and share a few words with us.
Thirdly, I would like to thank the organizing committee and all my campus ambassadors. Let's have a huge round of applause for them, because they have been trying to get in touch with you, and they were always there when you had any doubts. They were always there when I had any doubts. So from Mumbai, I was coordinating with them every day. So thanks a lot. Lastly, I would like to thank delegates. Delegates, you have been so patient. Delegates, I love to see your smiling faces, and I hope that you have this amazing 3 days of MUN experience. Welcome to the Indian International MUN Agra 2017 delegates.
International School, who has supported this initiative, Mr. Agnihotri,
who is the CEO of KNEWS and an eminent journalist of our country, the group director of the school, Dr. Ghanshyam Srivastava, the MD of the group, Madam Manjari Agarwal, and Mr. Rishi Jain, who has been I've been in touch with for the IIMUN conference in Agra. And because of the support and involvement of all these people, it's been possible for this evening's event to take place. And, you know, they've already spoken a little bit about the IIMUN, which is the International India International MUN. And I think the great work that is being done by the IIMUN is really in the interest of our country, of our youth, of the future. Because the aim of the IIMUN is to go beyond conventional education. And as one of them said, educating the youth is, I think it was Mr. Raj who said, educating the youth is something which is a wealth for the country, a wealth for humanity, wealth for our future. We are creating, we are investing in our future, we are creating wealth for our future by educating and reaching out to the youth. And the IIMUN has a unique, or the MUN really, the model UN sort of template, is something which helps the youth to look at issues with a fresh perspective, to analyze, to think, to debate. And that is very, very important before you arrive at any conclusion, any decision making, to think, to analyze, to debate, to look at all aspects of any problem. And the IIMUN has had many successes across the country and across the world, I'm told. So it is really something which is commendable.
हम इस देश के वासी हैं, जहां रोज ही दंगा रहता है, जहां रोज रोज अखबारों में स्कैमों का पंगा रहता है, जहां आम आदमी सड़कों पे इस हाल में भी, इस दौर में भी हर दिल में तिरंगा रहता है।
भविष्य जो सामने बैठा है, बहुत परिचित नहीं था MUN से। जब मेरे पास ये प्रस्ताव आया कि एक ऐसा कार्यक्रम है और मैं उसमें आऊं, यह आग्रह हुआ। फिर जीवेश ने कुछ सामग्री भेजी, उसको देखा, समझने की कोशिश की, तो मोटी बात जो मुझे समझ आई वो ये आई कि भाई हिंदुस्तान कल जिनको चलाना है वो लोग कल की तैयारी आज कैसे करें। कल हिंदुस्तान जिनके हाथ में आएगा तो हिंदुस्तान की ताकत भी उनके पास होगी और हिंदुस्तान की समस्याएं भी उनके पास होंगी। दोनों चीजें आती हैं जब आप कमान संभालते हैं। तो जो समस्याएं हैं उनसे आप कैसे जूझेंगे। अभी इस कार्यक्रम के शुरू होने से पहले हम आपके स्कूल के प्रिंसिपल साहब के साथ बैठे थे, तो एक बात चर्चा में आई, आज जो समस्याएं हमारे सामने हैं उनको लेके जो नई पीढ़ी है उसकी सोच क्या है, ये जानना समझना हमारे लिए, जो वर्तमान पीढ़ी है उसके लिए जरूरी है और नई पीढ़ी के लिए जरूरी है कि जो समस्याएं दशकों से भारत को प्रभावित करती आ रही हैं उन पर उनकी एक राय बने, एक चिंतन बने, एक धारणा बने, एक दृष्टिकोण बने।
ऑफ द कच्छ आई सॉ माय रेड ऑफ कल्चर्स माइंडसेट्स एंड व्यूज ऑल व्हिच डिफर्ड फ्रॉम रीजन टू रीजन। देयर वाज दो दैट वन थिंग दैट वाज मिसिंग इन एवरी रीजन दैट आई विजिटेड, दैट वन थिंग वाज फीलिंग ऑफ पेट्रियोटिज्म। Everyone either is a Bengali, Rajasthani, Gujarati, Mumbaikar or Delhiite. India, after rebellion against the British back in 1947, has never had a reason to unite together under one common banner. Today, after this long drought, we have finally found that reason. India is pushing for a permanent seat in the Security Council. Today, as India is developing in every sphere and our Prime Minister is meeting heads of nations of all across the world, I have found my reason. I want to mobilize all people in India across all age groups, religions, castes, socio-economic backgrounds to rally for India's bid for a permanent seat in the Security Council. I am rallying the youth of the country, training them, educating them and readying them to form the next set of leaders of the nation. I realize that it is not whom you are underneath, but what you actually do that defines you. I am what you define me to be. I am a change that you want to see. I am IIMUN. Now, we would like to present to you a small video on the Indian International MUN.
Independent India was a tender 15 years old when it was humiliatingly crushed by a far more focused, far more relentless adversary, China.
As the Indian Army and Air Force began operations in Kargil, the chief of the Pakistani Army, General Pervez Musharraf, went on an official visit to China. Kargil had unquestionably been an operation of the Pakistan Army.
A terrible
end with military decision.
This is perhaps the closest that comes to an attack with a shot of war.
10 men paralyze a city of 19 million.
We were absolutely numb. Everything seemed to be exploding.
हम इस समय पठानकोट के एयरपोर्ट स्टेशन के बाहर हैं। आप जो आवाजें सुन रहे हैं ये लगातार हेलीकॉप्टर से फायरिंग हो रही है। कुछ ऐसे स्थानों पर जो आप लड़ाकू हेलीकॉप्टर देख रहे हैं भारतीय वायुसेना का, इसी हेलीकॉप्टर से लगातार कुछ एक एरिया में फायरिंग की जा रही है। अब 17 ब्रेव सोल्जर्स ऑफ इंडियन आर्मी हैव बीन किल्ड एंड 19 हैव बीन इंजर्ड इन अ सुसाइड अटैक बाय पाकिस्तान बैक्ड पाकिस्तान ट्रेंड Pakistan funded and Pakistan armed terrorists at the Pakistan based JK Muhammad this one. This now has to stop. We have to retaliate and we have to punish. US, there is no time to wait. There is no time to deliberate and there is absolutely zero time to procrastinate anymore.
It's important to emphasize that, you know, this is a pretty considered and critically calibrated response by the Modi administration to the Uri attacks. I mean, I think this is, you know, this is best seen as a military jab rather than an all-out haymaker. Like, you know, they're clearly trying to signal to Pakistan that these type of incursions, these type of attacks just will not be tolerated and critically that they're not going to be costless for Pakistan.
First line, we should show no surrender. In practice, as an instrument of state policy, it is a war crime. But my country and other neighbors in our region are facing today is Pakistan's long-standing policy of sponsoring terrorism.
The UN Security Council is one of the 6 principal organs of the United Nations. The Security Council was created following the Second World War as an executive power. The Council membership is limited to 15 states, who are divided in 2 categories. First category is the following Big 5 permanent members: the Russian Federation, the United Kingdom, France, the People's Republic of China, and the United States of America, which represents the 5 great powers who won the Second World War. Each of the 5 permanent members has the veto power, which means that 1 negative vote is sufficient to block any resolution of the Council, regardless of the level of international support for the draft.
China has blocked India's move in the UN demanding action against Pakistan over release of Mumbai attack mastermind and LAT commander Zaki-ur-Rahman Lakhvi in violation of a resolution of the world body, as it contended that India provided insufficient information.
We are India at heart. important resource of this country is one single word. It's called youth of this country. It comes to world peace. Do we actually have world peace? I don't think so. Why don't we have world peace? It's simple. Because the real powers of today, the real powers of the 21st century, sir, are not represented in the Security Council. Point being, if 1.2 billion people cannot be dictated by five countries of the world, then it is only right that 1.2 billion people should be represented in the most powerful body of the world. Will you support India in its bid for the permanent seat in the Security Council? Thank you very much. We ended by saying this, and I will continue to maintain that. Indian at heart and internationally by Jai Hind.
International School presents the Indian International Model United Nations Agra chapter. Now, we would like to welcome the Secretary General, Mr. Rishi Jain, to come and share a few words with us.
Well, I know all of you guys must be extremely restless and sleepy. I won't bore you out, and also the competition for me is pretty high up to fantastic performances and to fantastic speeches. So I was just thinking to myself, when you guys applauded at the end of the very video, if I was half as attentive as you guys when I was in my school, I would have done much better. But before I go on rambling about something that's very close to me and the heart of the organization, there are a couple of things about me. Firstly, I love talking. Second, whenever I talk, people don't understand what I'm trying to say. So, just in case, if you happen to fall in the second bracket, please feel free to raise your hand and ask me to stop. Okay, as of now, we are good to go. So, moving on, we have a couple of problems in the world today. On one hand, we have ISIS. On the other, we have Donald Trump. Well, though we have a way around with the first one, the other one has no way around. And one word, one wants to destroy all the walls to unify, and other wants to make walls. Both are completely opposite, but they are the two problems that we have to handle. Now, I'll tell you a short story. How many of you here want to go abroad and study? Because we've been hearing about patriotism, nationalism, and how we should be Indian at heart. So can all those people, those who wish to study abroad or in any fancy university, can you please raise your hands? Okay, there's a couple of you. Okay. Do you guys know about what Ivy League universities? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. So, I had a friend who wanted to apply for an Ivy League university. Now, as usual, she filled her application form, applied. She was an exceptionally brilliant student, really good at academics, a very huge portfolio of her extracurricular activities, got certificates from BMO's office for various activities she had done. And she had interned at UN itself. Now, this girl, this friend of mine, she had this one habit. She loves talking. But the catch comes, the last process of the application round is the interview process. And she had a Skype interview scheduled. The entire 1 hour, 25 minutes interview went well. And the person who was taking the interview just went through her application once again and asked her question. How would you rate your general knowledge out of 10? She said, I don't read the newspaper often, However, I prefer doing stuff for the people instead. I prefer giving to the world, to the community. And she said, I would rate it at around 3 or 4. Now, that's pretty below average if you consider it out of 10. Then the interviewer asked her one question. That was, can you tell me who's the chief of ISIS? Can anyone tell me over here who's the chief of ISIS? Anyone? Yes, Baghdadi, that's correct. Now, she was not as brilliant as you guys. She panicked. She did not answer it. However, there was me and another friend of mine who were sitting behind the laptop. But we decided not to tell her. Because we wanted to mess with her. So we decided not to tell her. However, of course she got rejected. But they don't tell you the reason why you're rejected. So she sent the application for review. And she jotted down all the points that she might have done wrong. The only thing that it came down to was a knowledge about world affairs. Now, it might seem as if it's not important for us to know as to what's going on around the world. But think of it in this way. What if it's your family, it's your close friend who's getting affected by all of this, or any one of this? Would it matter to you then? Put yourself in those shoes. Would it matter to you then? Would you care about it more? Because we as Indians, as of 21st century, we do not care about it unless and until it happens to us or our close family members. We do not give a damn about it. Why should we even discuss it? Maximum we will do is read the headline and forget about it at the end of the day. Or gossip about it, or just say how bad our government is for not doing the job. But as Mr. Agnihotri sir said, it's not the government who does the job. They can just define it's up to you to be and make India forward. You have to take all the steps to make and move India forward. Remember, Abdul Kalam though said, we have India Vision 2020. It's up to you guys to implement it in your daily lives and to make sure that everything that you do is in respect to your country and is making your country proud. Now, moving on to my important point, and I'm sure most of you are restless over here, and this was rather a huge closing ceremony, so I won't take much of your time, I assure you that. But can anyone tell me, if you want to search something or anything that you don't know about, what's the first thing that you go to? Google, okay. Now, how many of us here love to use social media? Facebook, Instagram, and there's relatively something new called Snapchat. So, a lot of us. Now, for the elder ones, there's something called WhatsApp as well. How many of us love WhatsApp? Yes, fantastic. So, how many of us here love Domino's or Pizza Hut or McDonald's? Okay, majority of you. Okay. Where is Facebook based? Can anyone tell me which country the Facebook is based? Yes, USA. Which country is Apple or Google based? Okay. Which country is Domino's or Pizza Hut based? Okay, now let's take another analogy. How many of you here love cheese? Cheese fans? Okay, how all these people who said they love pizza, you can include cake as well. Do you know where cake or cheese, as a matter of fact, originated from? Anyone? We don't know. Okay, if you try to connect all the dots, you'll realize all these Western countries are trying to influence our lives. They're telling us you should do this, you should do that, this is your duty and this is what you're supposed to do. However, that was the 19th century wherein the world was moving towards the West. Now we are living in the 21st century wherein the capital of the world are moving to either Beijing, Tokyo or New Delhi. And it's only justified when these capitals get a proper say in the world matters. And hence, becomes the most important thing, that is the permanent seat of India in the Security Council. Unless and until the world, which requires India to be a permanent member, and India's citizen, which is the second largest, most populous country in the world, is represented equitably, we cannot have a proper say in the global matters. Do you guys know what the youth population in India? I know everyone is aware as to what's the population of India, but can anyone tell me as to what's the population, youth population of India? Any guesses? It's 356 million people. Now, 356 million is more than most of the P5 nations' entire population. So when there are so many young people in our country, when they come together and say that we have to do one thing, at least for 1 second, or at least for a while, the matters will be considered. Hence, when you wear a fancy blazer and you go and discuss in an MUN that this should be done to Sudan, or this should be done in Chechnya, or this should be done somewhere else, does it actually matter? Is it having any impact on our lives or our daily goals? No, it does not. So, how are the MUNs useful to you? Remember, MUNs teach you a lot. But when you come to an MUN, you learn about different people's ideologies. And it's the matters like permanent seat of India in the Security Council, when everyone hears about it, they will come together and they will have one voice and one opinion for it. So, IIMUN, this year as well, last year we went to UN headquarters, organized a conference over there. This year again, we got an opportunity and we are organizing a conference with 1500 people in the UN headquarters in New York. When we are organizing this conference, that's on 15th of August, we are going to go have a march over there, tell them we have this many people who support us and have demanded the permanent seat of Indian Security Council. Now, all you have to do is sign a petition saying, yes, I support India's bid in the Security Council. How many of you think India deserves a permanent seat in the Security Council? Okay, that's fantastic. Now, all those who say that India does not deserve, I can gauge two things. One, you don't know enough content on the matter, that's why you don't know what your opinion is. Second, you are just too bored and you want to go home. I'm going to go with the second one, because I am a patriot as well as a partial nationalist. So, remember, your country comes first, your service comes before that. But remember, service and country are way more important than you or anybody else. And your citizens are equally important. Now, if there's anybody here who's interested to come for a New York conference, you can come and speak to me. But that aside, I just want all of you here who's saying yes for India's permanent bid in the Security Council, just sign the petition which will be handed to you by the campus ambassadors and the OCs. And with that, I won't take it any further. And I will end with a quote. You give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. You teach a man how to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. Now, by the powers vested in me, I, the Secretary General of IIMUN Agra, declare this conference open. Now, the most cliched joke, cliched saying at IIMUN, Indian at heart, international in our mind, Jai Hind. Have a best day.
हमारे साथ है IIMUN के डायरेक्टर जनरल जीवेश की, उनसे हम बात करते हैं। आज ये सारा प्रोग्राम जो था वो बच्चों को लेकर टारगेट करके, उनकी ब्राइट फ्यूचर के लेके किया, टारगेट करके आप ये प्लान ला रहे हो भारत को आगे ले आने के लिए।
तो ये जो हमारा प्रोग्राम था वो सातवीं कक्षा से लेके जो 20 साल के लोग हैं उनके लिए था। ये प्रोग्राम में बच्चे डिप्लोमेसी के बारे में बात करते हैं, अलग अलग वर्ल्ड इश्यूज़ के बारे में बात करते हैं, और वो और काफ़ी इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ों के बारे में बात करते हैं। जैसे हमारे एक कमेटी है लोकसभा, लोकसभा में हम दलितों के बारे में बात करने वाले हैं अगले 3 दिनों में। ऐसे ही हमारी 4 और कमेटियाँ हैं जिसमें बच्चे एक टॉपिक पे डिस्कशन करेंगे और उस टॉपिक का हल निकालेंगे। तो हम सिर्फ ये चाह रहे हैं अपने एंड से कि बच्चों को आज जो हो रहा है वो पता रहे। आजकल के बच्चे कभी पढ़ते हैं, कभी नहीं पढ़ते हैं, कभी न्यूज़ देखते हैं, कभी नहीं देखते हैं। तो ये बहुत ज़रूरी है कि आज बच्चे न्यूज़ पढ़ें, जानें कि आज क्या हो रहा है, और जान पहचान करके फिर अपने आप को डेवलप करें। यूथ को आज ग्रो करना होगा, उनको अपने आप को और एक्सप्रेसिव बनाना होगा ताकि भारत पूरा देश प्रगति करे।
हमारे साथ यहाँ पर जनरल सेक्रेटरी ऋषि भी हैं, उनसे भी हम पूछते हैं कि आगे आपका ये जो संगठन है वो क्या प्लान कर रहा है।
ओके, सो MUN आजकल आप देखोगे तो MUN सिर्फ उन लोगों के लिए बन चुका है जो पैसा भर सकते हैं, जो अमीर है और बस अफोर्ड कर सकते हैं। तो हम ये प्लान कर रहे हैं कि MUN लोगों को मिले जिन लोग के पास ज़्यादा पैसा नहीं है और उनको एक्सपोजर मिले। जैसे एजुकेशन इंपॉर्टेंट है, वैसे MUN एजुकेशन को सस्टेन करने के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है। सो हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने आज ही एक कॉन्फ्रेंस किया मुंबई में, जो वर्ल्ड का सिर्फ लार्जेस्ट नहीं था बट वर्ल्ड का सबसे बड़ा फ्री कॉन्फ्रेंस था। तो ये कॉन्फ्रेंस एक बड़ा स्टेप है जिससे हम लोग आगे बढ़ने वाले हैं। उसके अलावा हमारे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में एक अनदर NGO है, उसका नाम है टेकिंग इंडिया फॉरवर्ड। और इस NGO में हम लोग बच्चों को पढ़ाते हैं और उन्हें सिखाते हैं, गांवों में जाके उन्हें सिखाते हैं कि ये होता है, उन्हें पढ़ाई और एजुकेशन के बारे में बताते हैं। और इसी के साथ NGO में हम लोग बाकी और भी काम करते हैं ताकि लोगों को और बच्चों को पता चले और एजुकेशन उन्हें मिले।
तो ये थे हमारे साथ जिवेश गर्ग और ऋषि थे, जिन्होंने साफ तौर पर अपने संगठन के कामकाज को लेकर बताया। उनका कहना है कि हमारे संगठन के थ्रू हम देश के बच्चों को आगे बढ़ाएंगे, उनके फ्यूचर को और ब्राइट करने का हमारी ये कोशिश रहेगी कि बच्चे आगे बढ़ें। कैमरा पर्सन सुरेंद्र के साथ सरिता गुप्ता, KNEWS आगरा।